Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica, and today we're doing my everyday makeup basket for November of 2018. Before we jump into the video, I do have a playlist of all of my makeup baskets monthly for this entire year, so I'll throw that up in the cards if you want to check it out. And before we jump in, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you like these monthly makeup baskets, and if you haven't and you'd like to, hope you would consider subscribing, hitting the little bell icon so you're notified whenever I post a new video every single Monday through Friday. So first things first, I did get my very first Pat McGrath eyeshadow palette, so that is going to be a product that I will be reaching for. It is literally brand new. I haven't even dipped into it yet because I do want to film the first time I ever use it. So while I am going to film my first impression, I'm not going to throw up just a first impressions video. I'm going to do a full review video on this. Hopefully it'll be out by the end of the month. If you don't already know, I always keep my current Project Pan projects in this bottom drawer right here, and this one is my Finish 6 by Solstice. I did just post my first update for that, so if you missed it, it'll be up in the cards. Let's move on to this drawer with all of my powders. For my bronzer and contour this month, I want to bring back an oldie but a favorite. This is the Tarte Clay Play, the original first palette that came out, and I adore the contour shade in this. This is my favorite contour shade of all time. I think the only one that even gets close is the one in that Smashbox palette that I had last month. But this bronzer, I can still make this work. It's not my favorite, but it is a good formula. The bronzer and contour shade over here at the very end is way too dark and I'll never really get use out of it. But I can also use all the eyeshadows in here. And the palette has a really nice big mirror and it just smells really nice too. So I'm bringing this back out to get more use out of those contour shades. For my blush this month, I'm bringing out a MAC and Patrick Star collab. This is a duo in I'm Not Blushing. I brought this back out for the first time today and used it, and I actually really liked the way that the light peach looked on me. So I'm going to put it in my everyday basket just to give it a little bit more of a chance. Thoroughly test it out. I'm still not a huge fan of like that bronzer. I think it's supposed to be like a deep blush, if I'm being honest. So I'm gonna use it more of just a neutral blush than as a bronzer. So we'll see how that works out this month. For my loose powders, I'm bringing out a mini of the Cover FX Matte Setting Powder in the shade Light. This is fairly, it's like brand new. This is one of the minis that you get either in one of their kits or as a point perk from Sephora. And I'm just working my way through my face powders because, spoiler alert, the face powder that I had in my Project Pan is already finished. So I'm gonna be bringing in another powder for me to use every day. Last but not least in my powder drawer, I'm actually bringing in my Pan That palette. And I'm bringing this in because I really want to focus on using the lighter two shades as face highlighters. So I'm not going to show you what the palette looks like because I am halfway through another month and another update. So you're just going to have to wait till the next update. But I'm really excited, and I think that by putting this in my everyday makeup drawer and focusing more on multitasking with it as opposed to just doing eye looks with it, that I'm really going to make some great progress. The next drawer up are foundations, and I only have a couple this month. I literally have not been able to put this foundation down. It's becoming a problem. I might pan this accidentally. This is the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage Foundation in the shade 030 Sand Beige. I do have two shades of the ColourPop No Filter Sticks Foundation. I have the shade Light 50W and Light 55C. I'm still testing this out. I can't give an opinion either way. I'm just confused. So I'm still testing it out. Hopefully I'll have this video out also by the end of the month. Another affordable foundation I've been testing out is the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Full Coverage Foundation. I love the full coverage concealer from this line, so I had to go out and try the foundation. I picked up the shades F6 and F5, since those are the shades that I got in the concealer. And I don't think they're the best shade match. I do have to use kind of both of them and mix them to work. But I'm almost done testing this out. I've been using it for a couple of weeks now. So this video should be out fairly soon. And that's it for foundations. My mascara drawer is a bit boring this month. I'm literally just carrying everything over because I want to hurry up and finish panning these so I can jump into some new mascaras next month. Also have a glitter glue from NYX, of course, and an Urban Decay primer potion. In my brow drawer, I'm mostly keeping it the same. I've actually been using my Pan That palette shade in my brows, so I haven't been reaching for this too often. But I do have brow pomades from ABH, Milani, and ColourPop, along with the Wet n Wild Ultimate Brow Mascara that's in the wrong shade. I just have it in here to remind myself to keep an eye out for the black shade, because I really want to try that in black. I have two clear brow gels, one from Milani, one from NYX. I have the NYX Epic Ink Liner in brown, and then I have a black liner from Givenchy there in the back. My concealer drawer didn't really change too much from last month. I'm trying to finish up a couple other concealers, but since I'm panning a concealer, I'm also not reaching for these as much. I have the Tarte Shape Tape in Light Medium Beige, or Light Medium Honey. I have the Flower Beauty Light Illusion Concealer, and I have the Urban Decay and Naked Skin Concealer. I do have something truly exciting in my primer drawer, and that is the new Tatcha Silk Canvas Primer. And if I'm not exaggerating when I say I love this primer. I've used it for just over a week now, and it feels so luxurious, like the most beautiful moisturizer. And it just looks good under all of my favorite foundations. It looks amazing. I'm also trying to finish up the sample of the Fenty primer that I have. And then also I have a little sample of another primer from Sephora up there that I got in the box when I got my Tatcha primer. So that's everything for this month. I feel like it's a little bit toned down. I tend to have more foundations and more face powder kind of things. But since I'm focusing on doing a few reviews and some focusing on my Pan That palette, I feel like I'm really paring down my everyday makeup to focus more on those projects. So thank you so much for watching. Hope if you guys liked it, you'll give it a thumbs up, and I cannot wait to see you in my next video. Bye!